I was lucky enough to get 6-star Stark Spider-Man from a What If Nexus crystal. So I'm going to do a direct comparison between my 5-star rank 4 Sig 200 Spider-Man and then my 6-star rank 1 Unawakened Spider-Man. Just going to do a direct comparison gameplay video. Synergy team is Vulture with plus 15% ability accuracy, Kamala Khan, which is stun, shock, and snare debuffs gain 30% duration. And then you have Mr. Negative. He gives Spider-Verse heroes dark energy, and you can use them to either inflict an armor break, a weakness, or a degeneration on the opponent. And then Green Goblin. Critical hits generate 15% more power. So obviously the big difference between my 5 and 6 star Spider-Man is the Awakened ability. The Awakened ability gives taunt debuffs 2 extra seconds duration, and also his poise charges gives him additional critical rating. So the 5 star is going to have more critical rating, but the 6 star just in his base kit has more damage. Also, what's a nice piece of utility from the Awakened ability is each poise charge also grants additional block proficiency, which is nice to have when you run Suicide Masteries like me, which is the next topic I want to talk about. So back in 2018, when I decided to get more serious about this game and I should commit to Marvel Contest of Champions, my top champion, my profile champion for the longest time, was a 5-star rank 4 Stark Spider-Man. And he was my best champ for like a year. He was my MVP for the longest time. And the reason I never took Spider-Man to rank 5 is I decided to use Suicide Masteries and make them permanent. And Spider-Man sucks with suicides. So that's the biggest reason I never took him to rank 5. Then the other reason is I wanted to wait until I got 5-star Blade and 5-star Ghost Rider so I can take all three of them to rank 5 together. But it took me so long. I never got 5-star Ghost Rider. I think I just got him last year, I think. So I waited like 2 years until I finally got a 5-star Ghost Rider. So I never took Blade or Stark Spider-Man to rank 5. So it's pretty clear. I guess the Awakened ability makes a big difference because the 5-star Awakened Spider-Man finished the fight with 78 hits, and then the 6-star Spider-Man finished with 95 hits. All right, this time I'm changing up the synergy team a little bit. I still have Mr. Negative, so we can deal degeneration, armor break, and weakness debuffs. And I have Blade, so we start the fight with 3 poise charges. And then to help with Suicide Masteries, I have Spider-Man 2099, which gives Stark Spider-Man block proficiency. And then we have War Machine, which can purify the bleed and poison debuff at the start of the fight. And these fights right here are going to be this month's Cavalier difficulty fights. So I just skip forward a little bit to the part of the fight where I have like 10 or 9 poise charges, and then we can start pounding into Cable here. And as you can see, we have block proficiency. Whenever we parry, there's a 30% chance for it to activate, I think, from Spider-Man 2099. And then also we are not suffering from bleed or poison because War Machine purified the bleed and poison for us at the start of the fight. So the inspiration for this video idea and the whole reason I'm doing this is obviously 6-star Spider-Man is not widely available. He's kind of a rare champ right now. So when I got him, and obviously it's super lucky, I just kind of assumed, well, I have to take him to rank 3, right? Like, he's such a rare, awesome champion. Even if he sucks with suicides, I can work around that. I gotta take him to rank 3. But then I was like, is the Awakened ability really that important? So that's really the whole reason why I'm doing this video, this comparison video, is to find out, like, is the Awakened ability really that important? And am I gonna miss it? Because my 6-star is obviously not Awakened. And once again, the 5-star beats the 6-star, but it's not that big of a difference this time. It's only 48 hits compared to 50 hits. All right, so this is the same content. It's the Cavalier difficulty for this month, but it's just a different fight. It's Strife now, a little harder to deal with compared to Cable. Looks like the critical rating boost from the Awakened ability is coming in clutch again, because the 5-star once again beats out the 6-star. 35 hits compared to 46 hits. Alright, this might sound a little silly, but Stark Spider-Man has actually been one of my favorite Hyperion encounters for a long time, and I'll explain why. So this is the tech variant, and this Hyperion is going to have double power gain. So, first, Stark Spider-Man has taunt debuffs, which makes it easier to bait out special attacks from Hyperion, and Hyperion has a lot of special attacks. And then you have the power drain on the heavy attack, which you can use in an emergency, just in case he gets the 3 bars of power. And if the AI just isn't working and it's just not, you can't bait out the special attacks, you can use a special one to just stun lock the opponent and just stun him over and over and over again. Because you can stun him from the special one and do a 7-hit combo, then use another special one. So you can just stun chain and stun lock him until you can get another power drain or just until he's dead. Honestly, right here, I have no idea why there's such a big difference in how I messed up so bad with the 6-star compared to the 5-star. I guess this is just more proof the Awakened ability is pretty important when it comes to damage. One last little thing right here I want to show off of Spider-Man that he's really known for is the assisted evade when it comes to special attacks. When it comes to really annoying special attacks that have a lot of projectiles or a lot of blocked hits, it's awesome that Spider-Man can just evade all of it like that. This is another one of those fights where the hit count at the end isn't really a big difference. 28 hits compared to 30, but still just even more proof. The 5-star Awakened ability definitely has more damage compared to the unawakened 6-star. So final verdict and my final thoughts are, I was still impressed with Stark Spider-Man, and his damage is still really awesome even in 2021. That I get the opportunity to have him as a 6-star, I think I will take him into rank 3. I'm just going to hold off for a little bit right now because I want to see if I can get Nimrod as a 6-star. And if I can't, then yeah, I'm going to definitely take Spider-Man to rank 3. Even though the 5-star has more damage from the Awakened ability, it's not that big of a difference. It's just like 5-hit difference or like 10-hit difference here and there. So